Local Disclosures, AAA Equities, Matthew Cabangon. Will, finally good to have you with us for these very spicy news lineup that we have.
Yeah, Mimi, I have to come out of vacation to cover all these exciting events.
Thanks
for having me.
Okay, thank you for making the time. Let's start with PLDT. How bad might it get for your money if you're invested in PLDT at a time when, you know, some are actually hoping for a year-end rally and then this blows up?
Well, Mimi, I feel like the PLDT situation ultimately is one issue, one core issue that everyone is asking. And that question is, where is the money? You know, 48 billion pesos is a lot of money for the company to be losing track of. And while the official release has mentioned that this is a what they are calling a CapEx overrun, you know, investors still have a lot of questions on what exactly that means. Does that mean they overbuilt last year? You know, did they build too many towers, you know, laid too many cables? Or could something more nefarious have happened? Mm-hmm. Or could this have been a 48 billion peso honest mistake? I don't know. We don't have a lot of details yet. So right now, the viewer's guess is as good as mine as to the extent of what the problem really is. Now, as far as the share price is concerned, this issue reflects very poorly on the internal risk management, on the internal oversight over at PLDT. After all, you know, we're not talking about, you know, pennies here. This is a large sum of money that a very large bureaucratic organization lost track of. So it says a lot that of, you know, the myriad upper level executives at PLDT, you know, who was keeping their eye on the ball here? Mm-hmm. And I think that's the big issue that has led to the stock price being sold down aggressively.
You know, Will, Twitter is abuzz over this PLDT story. There was one market observer who actually noticed that, you know, when you look at the management list, the top management executives of PLDT, there are over 30 of them listed at the PSE website, whereas San Miguel, for example, only has, I think, 5 or less than 10 top-level management executives. And when you look at the wipeout, the value, the amount of money that's been wiped off the share price of PLDT over the last 2 days, that's Friday and then yesterday, that's what, nearly 100 billion pesos, which is, if you compare it, is already the market cap of Metro Pacific. That is how deep the sell-off has been. How much further do you think can this go?
Well, maybe it's really tough to say. As the market opened a few minutes ago, PLDT sold off even more. When I checked before I came on the show, it was down about 3%. Mm. You know, it's difficult for us to gauge how much further this stock will go lower because, you know, there's a lot of unanswered questions still. Mm-hmm. I think there was a report yesterday or the day before that you know, that 48 billion peso number used to be north of 100 billion, and they've somehow brought that figure down. Of course, the question is, what happened, right? What was the 100+ billion figure, and what did they figure out that brought it down to 48? We're wondering, are there knockoff effects here, right? Does this affect their loans, for instance? PLDT has a lot of creditors, right? And that amount of money missing, you know, does that affect their cash flows to operate, to service their debt? You know, there's just so many sort of second and third wave effects from such a big amount of money missing that we don't have any visibility yet. So I think investors, and particularly in trading this stock, will be very cautious. I don't see it stabilizing until we see a definitive resolution to this issue.